Hi, and welcome to this holiday edition of CPSB-TV at College Street Vocational Center. I'm Terrian.
And I'm Jabari. Here's a look at what we have in store in the December show. It's a trip of a lifetime for a local student as she chases her dream to be a professional news anchor.
And from Christmas movies to music and traditions, Dragging the Halls is all about the holidays.
Plus, see what students use to recreate effects from one of our favorite scenes in Home Alone. First, our top story today, a huge honor and opportunity for one of our own television production crew members.
11th grader Layla Benoit has been selected as one of only 12 students across the country to be a part of an incredible program to learn from industry professionals. Here's CPSB-TV's Tyrese Green.
Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Layla Benoit is a second-year television production student at College Street Vocational Center and a junior at LaGrange High School.
Reporting for CPSB-TV.
She is known amongst her classmates as hardworking, inspiring, and passionate in all of her projects. All of that effort has led Layla being chosen for the competitive PBS Student Reporting Lab's Winter Academy this December.
I decided to apply because I thought it would be a good opportunity for me and to be more experienced in the broadcasting industry and work with peers from all over the country who are my age who has the same passion and motivation as me in the broadcasting industry.
Television production instructor Brittany Glazer has taught Layla for 2 years and says she knew this program would be a perfect fit.
She is a second-year television production student, and she stands out every day as a leader, as a hard worker. And when there's a project after school hours or on a weekend, she is truly always the first one to sign up. So I was eager to connect her with that opportunity, and I also know this is the career path she wants, and she's going to shine with this.
Layla will fly to Austin, Texas on December 16th and spend 5 days working with 11 other students and mentors from across America to learn the ins and outs of the broadcasting industry.
I'm most excited to meet everybody in person and just to like see like the different things that they do and just like be more hands-on with the cameras and the gimbals and the drone. I'm excited to use the drone.
With Layla's experience in this class, she has excelled locally. Now she says she's looking forward to expanding that knowledge and bringing it back home.
The biggest thing I can take away from it is like, they actually selected me because they could have chosen anybody else out of the whole country because there was a lot of people who applied for it. And I just feel like since they picked me, it's a good experience for me. When I come back, I can learn more and more and more. And also it's something that I like to do.
Reporting for CPSB-TV, I'm Tyrese Green.
To be selected for the PBS Winter Academy, Layla had to write an essay and produce a video explaining why she wanted to participate. At the end of the learning week, she will be part of a showcase screening at Austin's PBS station showing the student-produced stories.
We have another couple of big shout-outs. Congratulations to our very own principal, Mr. Justin Mahoney, for being named Calcasieu Parish High School Principal of the Year. Mr. Mahoney has been principal at College Street for 12 years. He is now in the running of the State Principal of the Year. We talked to him about how much this award means to him.
I am so proud to represent College Street Vocational Center on the state level. For so many years, what we do here has not been recognized, particularly on a larger level. And I am so pleased. I'm very grateful to Calcasieu Parish School Board for choosing me, and I'm so honored for that. And more than a personal honor, I am honored for all the CTE workers, past and present, who've worked so hard to get us to this point. And I'm so proud to represent our school.
Congratulations again to Principal Mahoney.
College Street is also proud to have the Calcasieu Parish High School Counselor of the Year. Terri Shaw has worked in education for 33 years, 13 of those as a school counselor. Here at College Street, she helps with everything from class selections to career counseling to everyday needs like clothing and food.
It's such an honor to be Counselor of the Year. And I think my biggest accomplishment through that is being able to represent my field well and to let people know that there are so many wonderful counselors in our parish.
This is Ms. Shaw's second time to be named High School Counselor of the Year in Calcasieu Parish.
The countdown on to Christmas break, and so are chances to get your grades in place. Christmas break lasts from Wednesday, December 20th through Wednesday, January 3rd. We come back to school on January 4th, so the date is also the last night week of the last 9 weeks. That means your grades won't be changing after break. All right, guys, no skipping classes, playing around. That means come to school and be on your A game. From your favorite Christmas movies to songs, traditions, we hit the halls to find out what you like best.
Actually, CPSB-TV's DeAndre Jason did just that for this month's Jay and the Hoss.
What's up, what's up, what's up? So it's Drain the Halls, and I'm back with another edition of Drain the Halls. So today, I'm here with...
Alana.
Alana who?
Alana Cannon.
Period, queen. So do you have any, like, Christmas tradition that your family do every year?
We have a second Christmas.
What is that?
Two Christmases.
Okay, can you go more into detail?
So we have one Christmas where everybody eat, and the second Christmas is where everybody party.
So basically, Christmas Eve and Christmas. Oh, okay. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Oh, y'all, so we just, what's up, y'all? I'm here with...
Leah Foot.
What's your favorite Christmas song?
2 hours later.
Probably Jingle Bells. I don't Christmas music.
So are you going to sing it?
No.
Why not?
I just listen.
Okay.
Okay.
What's up, what's up, what's up? And I'm here with...
Aviana
who?
Touche.
Period.
I got a question for you. You ready to answer it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What's your favorite Christmas candy?
The candy canes, like the flavored ones, not the peppermint. The one that tastes like Jolly Ranchers and all that.
I'm here with...
Kaylee Fontenot.
Okay, Kaylee, what's your favorite Christmas song?
Jingle Bell Rock.
You want to sing it?
Jingle Bell.
And that's your favorite Christmas song?
Yeah.
Period. I'm here with...
Justice.
Justice who?
Gidry.
Okay, Justice. What's your favorite Christmas movie?
Polar Express.
Why is that?
Just a good traditional Christmas movie.
I think we can all agree that Home Alone is one of the Christmas movie classics that we all like. But have you really thought about what goes into making a movie like that? Our class took on the challenge through a Foley sound project. Here's a behind the scenes look followed by our program's top Foley edit.
This project challenged us to recreate the sounds in a booby trap scene from Home Alone. Foley sound is the art of creating sound effects using everyday objects. Some of the sounds we needed to recreate included Mar fighting the door to break into the McAllister house, the creaking sounds in the basement, a few falls, and several footsteps. To make these sounds, we used sticks, leaves, and a rock, various doors, dropping backpacks, and boots on different flooring surfaces. This project pushes students to work together to make a scene feel and sound authentic. I enjoy being one of the Foley directors, reimagining how different items could make the sounds we needed. The biggest challenge was keeping people on task, but overall, I still enjoyed it, and we had lots of fun.
Oh boy, that's it. You little brat. Not this time. Yes.
Thank you.
Christmas isn't complete without going to theaters to see a new release. We've got plenty of options for you to choose from this month.
Here's CPSB-TV Luke Hargrave with a special holiday edition of Director's Chair.
Welcome to a special holiday edition of The Director's Chair. I'm Luke, and we've got a lot to cover today, with new movie releases in time for Christmas, and some nostalgic classics you can catch on the big screen. First up, we've got a trio of Marvel Superwomen in The Marvels. When their superpowers become entangled with one another thanks to a wormhole, Captain Marvel, Miss Marvel, and Monica Rambeau team up to figure out how to fix their situation, plus tackle a new cosmic threat. Next up is the pre-Katniss prequel that centers on the Hunger Games going from violence to spectacle with the Hunger Games The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. Now to a character we've all grown up with, our parents and grandparents too, Willy Wonka. This is another prequel, but this one's set before Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. It's about a young Willy Wonka and his dreams of owning a sweet shop that doesn't go according to plan. Christmas Day will bring out a few new releases, including the re-envisioned musical adaptation of The Color Purple. This one hits on tough topics in the South, including domestic violence, abuse, racism, and poverty. If you are looking for something the whole family can enjoy, there's Journey to Bethlehem, which is like High School Musical merging with the Nativity story. There's also the third installment of the Trolls franchise with Trolls Band Together. In Disney's new release, Wish, all about good versus evil and a hero who happens to have a really cute goat. And finally, if you're wanting a walk down memory lane, Cinemark is bringing back its holiday movie clubhouse with discounted tickets for some familiar favorites. There's Arthur Christmas, Polar Express, and The Grinch. Looks like there's a little something for everyone this Christmas. I'm Luke in the Director's Chair.
As we know, Christmas can get pretty expensive from gift shopping to decorating.
And this month, what's trending? CPSB, Shamisha Gurley takes a look at the discount site Temu to see if it lives up to the hype.
What's trending? Temu, where you can get everything you name for cheap prices. But the thing is it legit? Let's hit the halls and find out.
I decided to buy AirPods from Temu. At first I just wouldn't know they worked, you know, if it was for legit. And when I got them, it was. So yeah, it was just like all my regular AirPods that I had that I got from, you know, Walmart or Apple or something.
On Amazon, you could buy something for like $20, maybe $40, but on Temu, they'd be like $15, lower.
I heard about Temu from my friend. I really want to buy this shirt is I needed an outfit to match my shoes. I didn't really like the quality too much because of the fabric it was made out of. It was like $10.
I'm going to have to try this app out for myself. If you find yourself getting a lot of emails from them, they love sending out promotions like 80% coupons and more deals. From What's Trending, I'm Shamisha Guillory.
If you're looking to shop locally and get unique homemade items or food, check out our local farmers market.
There are markets in Lake Charles, Safford, and Mars Bluff. This video is from the Cash and Carries Farmers Market in Lake Charles. Every Tuesday from 4 to 6 p.m., vendors are set up selling everything from baked goods, herbals, teas. Product isn't the only thing that brings us together. It is the community.
Our mission statement is to put Louisiana beef on Louisiana tables, and we have found a home at the market, and we have found a good support community at the markets, and so we enjoy coming. We love seeing our customers each week. We love being able to interact with them face to face, and this is how we choose to do our business.
So I became the farmers market manager in 2017. It was a job interview, and I really enjoyed the culture and the people and the whole vibe of just being in a farmers market, the natural, the trading between ourselves, growing our own food, natural products, and I really loved that you could experience things about people by what they sold, what they made. It felt like you got to get to know people just by what was offered on their table, and it just was a nice connection.
Other farmers market in the area include the Charleston's Farmers Market that happens in downtown Lake Charles every Saturday morning. There's also the Moss Bluff Market next to McDonald's every Saturday morning as well. So don't miss out on this year's Christmas themed gifts, trinkets, and stocking stuffers. That will do it for this Christmas edition of CPSB-TV. I'm Terrian.
I'm Jamari. I hope you all have a happy and safe holiday. See you next time.